Good morning.
Welcome to Faith Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Peter Kirsch. We are a caring body of Christian believers. Together we are learning and growing in faith, striving for peace and witnessing to the love of Christ. We serve the church, our community, and the world. Special welcome to the guests and visitors who are with us this morning, especially those joining us through social media. There's a lot of announcements and special events and meetings that are occurring coming up in here at Faith and in our community. As you can see, by those of you that have a bulletin in front of you or can access one through our church website, I won't go through all the announcements myself, but is there any person that would like to highlight any of the announcements this morning? Yes, I see Phil right here.
Yeah, just a quickie. There's a blood drive is this week, so there'll be no boom markers and no transfats either. So if you want to get blood, come on.
Yeah. As most of you are probably aware, we are doing our Christmas tree of giving to Tomac, where we're giving gifts to the children who are. Some of them don't have enough kind of stuff. So I thank all of you who have taken names and brought gifts back already, buying things. There are still 3 kids left that we need to get gifts for. So if you're of a mind to, and if you can, pick a name. Also, you need to sign for those names when you take them. Somebody took a name last week and you can sign for it. It's not a big deal unless we don't get the gift back. So if you remember you took somebody and didn't sign for it, please do. Scarlet, 76 or something, 77. So if you did take one last week, you need to sign for it today. And thank all of you who are already bought stuff back. More coming in now today. So that's it.
You ever celebrate? Oh, yes.
Amen.
Holy One,
we confess that we are not awake for you. We are not faithful in using your gifts. We forget the least of our siblings. We do not see your beautiful image in one another. We are infected by sin that divides your beloved community. Open our hearts to your coming. Open our eyes to see you and our neighbor. Open our hands to serve your creation. Amen.
Beloved, we are God's children, and Jesus, our beloved, opens the door to us. Through Jesus, you are forgiven. By Jesus, you are welcome. In Jesus, you are called to rejoice. Let us live in the promise prepared for us from the foundation of the world.
Amen.
Our first hymn this morning is found in our brief and simple worship, number 220, in God our Help in Ages Past.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Righteous God, our merciful Master, you own the earth and all its peoples, and you give us all that we have. Inspire us to serve you with justice and wisdom, and prepare us for the joy of the day of your coming. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated and may be here today.
The first reading is from 7:5.
Zephaniah.
Be silent before the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is at hand. The Lord has prepared a sacrifice. He has consecrated his guests. At that time, I will search Jerusalem with lamps, and I will punish the people who rest complacently under the dregs who stay in their hearts. The Lord will not do good. You are going to do harm. Their wealth shall be plundered, their houses laid waste. Though they build houses, they shall not inhabit them. Though they plant vineyards, they shall not drink wine from them. The great day of the Lord is near, near and hasting fast. The sound of the day of the Lord is bitter. The warrior cries aloud there. That day will be a day of wrath, a day of distress and anguish, a day of ruin and devastation, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of trumpet blast and battle cry against the fortified cities and against the lofty mountains. I will bring such distress upon people that they shall walk like the blind, because they have sinned against the Lord. Their blood shall be poured out like dust, and their flesh like thumbs. Neither their silver nor their gold will be able to save them on the day of the Lord's wrath. In the fire of his passion, the whole earth shall be consumed. For a full and terrible end, he will make all of the inhabitants on earth. The word of God, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm will be read responsibly, Psalm 90. Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to another.
Before the mountains were brought forth, where the land and the earth were born, from age to age you are God.
You turn us back to the dust and say, turn back, O children of the earth.
For a thousand years in your sight are like yesterday, when it is past and like a watch in the night.
You sweep them away like a dream. They fade away suddenly like the grass.
In the morning it is green and flourishes. In the evening it is dried up and withered.
But we are consumed by your anger. We are afraid because of your wrath.
Our iniquities are set before you, and our secret sins in the light of your countenance.
When you are angry, all our days are gone. We bring our years to an end like a sigh.
The span of our life is 70 years, perhaps in strength even 80. Yet the sum of them is but labor and sorrow, for they pass away quickly, and we are gone.
Who regards the power of your wrath? Who rightly fears your indignation?
So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom.
The second reading is from Thessalonians, first book. Now, concerning the times and the seasons, brothers and sisters, you do not need to have anything written to you, for you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night, when they say there is peace and security. Then sudden destruction will come upon them, as labor pains come upon a pregnant woman, and there will be no escape. But you, beloved, are not in darkness, for that day to surprise you like a thief. For you are all children of light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. So then let us not fall asleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who are drunk get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober and put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. For God has destined us not for wrath, but for obtaining salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, so that we, whether we are awake or asleep, we may live with him. Therefore, encourage one another and build up each other, as indeed you are doing. The word of God, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
ever leave school? She does. That's cool. Are you going to have Thanksgiving with your hungry tattoo? Okay, awesome. Do you like turkey job? Sometimes you do. Sometimes you might do like everything else that goes with Thanksgiving dinner. You like to grow it in your garden?
Yeah.
And then you like it?
Yep.
Okay. You're like, wow, that's awesome.
I just grow a green color
fruit. Yep.
Just clean them all.
Yeah, you have to now because it's all cold, right? What apples? Your favorite of all?
Yeah.
Well, I hope you get some out. I'm sure you will for Thanksgiving. A dinosaur?
Yeah.
I have a question to ask you. Did anybody ever say anything to you that hurt your feelings and made you feel sad inside? You know what they did? They call you a lady in school. Yeah, that hurts your feelings, right? But you're a big girl.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah.
And I'm a little boy.
And you're a little boy, but you're getting bigger. Aren't you? Yeah, you're getting bigger, which is awesome. Well, I think all of us have had times in our life when people have said things to us and it's hurt our feelings. And I can remember when I was little, even in school, people said things to me, and I still remember them as old as I am. So it's hard, it's really hard. And there was a saying when I was growing up, I don't know if you know it, but it was like, sticks and stones will hurt my bones, but names will never hurt me. You ever hear that? Well, that's sometimes when they say that to you, I'll write it down for you, you can say that to them when they say you, okay? Yeah, you can say that to them. But. Well, in today's scripture, which Lois read, Paul is telling the Thessalonians to encourage people and build people up. So that's not saying things that are nasty to them, right? So he wants us to encourage us to try to get people to feel better about themselves, because everybody has certain talents, right? And so I have in my bag here, this is actually from vacation bag, but I have in here some little notes that you can take, and you can actually take some home too. But would you like to dig in there and take a note out? And this can be for you, and you can probably read it for us. Each of you have one. Okay. Charlotte, can you find one too? Okay. It's a tiny bag, isn't it? Okay, you can have one more. That's good. That's good. Okay. Good job. All right. Now, can you read it? And what does it say? You are amazing. Yeah. That is wonderful. How about that, Charlie? What does yours say? You are beautiful. How about handsome? Is that better? I'm going to give you these because there's all good things to say to people when they say, you're feeling sad. Right? Maybe someone's missing, especially this Thanksgiving. Maybe somebody's missing someone, especially, that was always here at the Thanksgiving. So you take this bag, and there's several other in there, okay? And you can use them, and you can even give them to somebody at school that says you are little, you say. Okay, you are amazing. Everyone is loved. And it's important for us to tell other people that they are amazing too, right? And Heavenly Father, thank you for these wonderful children. Thank you for being with us, and help us to realize, as Paul told the Thessalonians, we should be encouraging always for other people.
and not tear them down, to fill them up as you and Jesus taught us. And all God's children said,
Amen.
Thank you. I have some things we could cover too.
Thank you, Judy and our youth, for helping us understand about our task to lift others up. I can't believe it's November already. Thanksgiving around the corner? Where did the year go? I can see by the nonverbal responses that we thought of it, are hearing it, are living it at this time. Well, we are also entering the last couple weeks of the church year. Besides the quick passage of time that seems to be all around us, the leaves dropping off the trees, the cooler temperatures, setting our clocks back and gaining more darkness and less light. A lot of things are changing around us. Where did the year go? Our scriptures today, and often in these last weeks of the church year before Advent season, which is the beginning of the church year, often lift up the end of times, the coming of the Lord, and also ponders the shortness of human life. Today's Psalm, Psalm 90, is a good example of this meditation on the quickness of time and the shortness of human life. What our Psalm reading today ended with in verse 12 says, "So teach us to number our days, that we may have a wise heart." Or, "Teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom." It's an interesting verse, because it's the only time this phrase is found in the entire Bible. Teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Time that is slipping by, it seems, changes in life, all in the shadow and the embrace of an eternal God. What does to gain a wise heart mean, do you think? Well, I thought about that because that first reading stuck with me all week. I feel in a way to gain a wise heart is to see what God is up to in the world, what God is doing around us, where we see God's action, where do we see evidence of God's footprints, God's fingerprints, God's action, and also to gain a wise heart is to find our place in the midst of what God is doing around us, in us, and through us. To gain a wise heart, I feel, is to find our place in God's story in the world. Every baptized Christian has a place in God's story. It's our vocation. It's our special calling to serve God and our neighbor. Any job or career in our life is holy when it is carried on as a vocation of God's plan for the sake of God and for others. Our calling in life, our daily vocation, can be in our home, at the place where we work, in school, in our church, in our community. Our calling in life can be many things. And we can be called to various things throughout our entire life. We can be called to be a child to our parent. We can be called to be a parent. Called to be a grandparent. Called to be a great-grandparent. called to be a son or a daughter, called to be a nephew or niece to our family, called to be a cousin, called to be a sibling to our sisters and brothers. In my life, calling is a familiar term because our ordained pastor is often said to have been called to the ministry. But I also have many other callings that may be not as pronounced. I am called to be a husband to my wife, a father to my son. I am called to be a neighbor to my neighbors, and a family member to my extended family. I've been called to be a friend to my acquaintances. And I'm also being called to be a citizen to our country. We have many callings in life. Are we using them? Or are we living them out with God's grace? Are we letting God's light shine through us as we live out our callings? In today's gospel, Jesus shares the parable of talents. And I think Jesus is calling to his followers and to us and asks us, what have you been called to do? And what are you doing with what you have been called to do? That not only our gifts and our talents and our skills, but I believe also our calling as God's children of light in the world that has so many shadows and darkness. Through our calling to follow Christ, God has a place for each of us where we can make a difference by living out our calling as God's child, where we have an opportunity to share God's love in acts of kindness and compassion and mercy, to regard those who are overlooked, to welcome the stranger, to care for the rejected and forgotten. We are not to squander our opportunities to witness to others. There is a story about Martin Luther and his relationship with his friend and fellow reformer, Philip Langton. That Philip Langton wrote Martin Luther a letter saying he needed help knowing what to do next in pushing forward the great Reformation task. And when Philip Langton having wondered, should he do this, should he do that? And Martin Luther responds in his letter in a famous quote, "You need to sin boldly, not to hesitate, but to trust in the grace of God." To sin boldly with acts of love and to rely on the grace of God. We may hesitate in our callings, whatever they may be, to be a witness to God's love, to extend ourselves, to share compassion. Maybe it's in a public place. Maybe it's someone we don't know. But we are called to be children of the light and to sin boldly, to extend ourselves as our calling, as we are called to. As Judy shared about Paul's letter to the Thessalonians, we are to live our lives faithfully, he said to them. By God's calling, we are children of the light and children of the day. God has destined us for salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. So we have confidence in that hope and assurance so that we can direct our lives today with God's grace, to encourage one another and build each other up. May we continue to let God's word instruct us, to live fully wherever God has called us to be God's people, so that we may apply wisdom to our hearts, so that others may know of our love in God's word. Amen.
Amen.
By the deep singing the hymn of the day, which is found in our book on page 7, Christ, we are one.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You teach us to count our days that we may gain a wise heart. Where there is sickness or sorrow, bring healing. Where there is loneliness, reveal your love and community. We remember before you. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for the faith formation ministries of our church. Give to all children, youth, and adults who study your word the breastplate of faith and love. Shape us by your love and show us how to encourage one another. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray especially, O God, for Pastor Michael Ryan, Rachel, Jen, Sharon, Gary, Lucille, Ryan, Julie, Dan, Muriel, Merle, David, Mars, Tom, Valerie, Gus, Slitlana and Anthony, Dennis, Joyce, Hardy, and the congregation of St. Mark Lutheran Church in Evansville. And we pray for others we name aloud now or silently in our hearts. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, you are faithful in all generations. For the promise of life and rest, and for the witness of those who have died in faith, we praise your goodness. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We offer our spoken prayers and those held in our hearts, trusting in your mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace, Molly.
Let us pray. God of all goodness, generations have turned to you, gathered around your table, and shared your abundant blessings. Number us among them, that as we gather these gifts from your abundance, we give thanks for your rich blessings. We may feast upon your very self and care for all that you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our sovereign and servant.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should. should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
But deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
There's a place for you at the banquet. Come and eat.
Mercy on us, mercy on us.
body of Christ is in the body of Christ. May stand for a blessing. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. be to God.